I'm calling this meeting a special meeting of council to order on January 23rd. Roll call.
Maddox.
Here.
Russell.
Here.
Hart.
Here.
Cobb.
Here.
Kuda.
Here.
Larson.
Here.
Okay, we're here for one thing only, which is passing of a resolution on first reading. Mayor, did you want to say anything regarding the resolution, regarding the legislation?
Thank you, Madam President. So first, thank you, Council, for coming in a bit early to consider this resolution. We have been working pretty diligently to try to find a good deal on EVs for the planning department, planning and development department, which, as you know, now includes housing inspection, zoning inspection, and those sorts of activities that require being out in the community. And one of the limiting factors that we discussed during the budget hearings was the fact that we don't have enough in the way of vehicles for inspectors. And that's one of the reasons why, even if you hire an inspector, if they don't have a way to get out into the community to do the inspections, then, you know, having the employee doesn't necessarily mean that the work gets done in an effective or efficient way. So in accordance with, you know, our goal to transition our fleet from internal combustion engines, we took a look for good deals on electric vehicles, and we were able to find electric vehicles that were a bit lower than our estimation at the end of the year as we were producing the budget, and lower than the state bid, I believe, that we were able to find. Yes. And Director Unetic has a bit more information about that pricing.
So the total pricing of these, each of them is going to be under $29,000. The state bid pricing is right around $35,000. So obviously it's below state bid pricing. And because they were so low, we were able to purchase, if council says we could purchase 6 vehicles instead of 5 vehicles.
That's part of the reason why we can purchase the 6. The other part is that our estimated budget for chargers and vehicles was in the realm of $250,000. Now, what we've been able to do is get an alternate mechanism for producing the chargers. Instead of spending $45,000, $50,000 per charger, we would spend substantially less than that to construct the charging apparatus in our parking lot, which allows us to redirect money from chargers to an additional electric vehicle, which is sorely needed. You know, our looking at our capital requests, we were hoping to purchase 5 electric vehicles. This will allow us to purchase 6, which is not exactly how many we need, but gets us closer to that number in an ongoing way. And, you know, the expectation is that we'll be adding to the fleet gradually over the years. But in this case, we were able to figure out a way to spend less on chargers, which means we can have the same number of chargers, but a larger number of vehicles for the employees to use to fulfill their duties.
Thank you. Okay. This is Municipal Services, so Vice President of Municipal Services.
Thank you, President Hart. Resolution 009-2023, first reading, a resolution authorizing an agreement with Vandiver Chevrolet for the purchase of 6 Chevy Bolts EV and declaring the necessity that this legislation become immediately effective as an emergency measure.
Is there a second? Okay, discussion. Ms. Larson?
Thank you, President Hart. I just wanted to say that I appreciated the answers that Mayor Sarin gave to me via my email request, and he also reiterated it again. I just have one question. How many chargers will you have then when you get that money, budgeted money spent?
So our initial estimate for chargers was 2 chargers for $100,000.
Yes.
In this case, we can still do 2 potentially, but we could potentially do more than 2 to accommodate those chargers. Now, all the cars won't have to be charging at the same time. Obviously, we were looking at two chargers for five cars. They don't need to be charged every night necessarily, given the usage. So we could still do two, or we could potentially do three or four for the money that we'd be spending.
Correct.
Thank you. I intend to vote yes on this legislation.
Any other comment? Yes, Councilor Kuda.
Yes, Mayor. Is using your own personal vehicle and getting mileage an option for city employees like inspectors?
It is always potentially an option. It is not our preferred option.
Sure. And has anybody balanced out what's, you know, like more cost efficient, you know, having a car or doing the mileage thing?
From my perspective, it's not just the cost. It's also a question of requiring employees to use their personal vehicles for city work. If we made that a requirement, it feels to me, you know, if their personal car breaks down and they need to continue doing their work, you know, they can't rely necessarily on, you know, the city fixing it. If they have trouble fixing it, then that means that they're not able to do the work if they need the car to do it. Mm-hmm. So we'd prefer to provide the transportation, provide the equipment. In the same way, we don't require any of our, you know, tradespeople to use their own tools.
Right. I understand there are other factors. And then lastly,
The director just mentioned that there are also potential insurance concerns, right, and considerations about that too.
You just said a moment ago that this is not all the vehicles we need, but, you know, so what are we looking at here in addition to the six?
The beginning of our conversation at the beginning of budget was...
Let me just clarify. I'm specifically speaking to Director Zamp's domain.
Yeah, and if need be, the director, if you have more insight to add to this, but I can start at least thinking about the beginning of our conversation as we were figuring out what our capital budget request would be. Mm-hmm. Started with sort of an overarching, possibly eight vehicles that would be necessary. Now I think that we can potentially make do with these six, or obviously with the five that we were planning on purchasing. But the additional vehicle will make it more efficient and more effective in rotation for the number of inspectors that will be using them. And that, in addition to the cars that we already have in the fleet, we can provide for enough transportation to make this work as we staff up in inspectional services.
So this goal of eight would be something that might be in a future, the additional.
Correct.
Be in a future budget that's not.
Yeah. More a gradual capacity building than an immediate capacity building, especially considering, you know, over the years, what we'll probably want to do is start replacing, you know, a few at a time. We do have, I think, more urgent need for additional equipment now so that we can ramp up in inspectional services and start bringing back in-house some of the things that we've already discussed related to that. But over the years, what we expect to do is replace a few at a time so that we can be a bit more incremental in our capital sort of upgrades so we don't have to drop a large amount of money every single time we want to upgrade the fleet, but instead do it in a more staged way.
Thank you.
Councilor Russell.
Mayor, what's the total staffing that you are going to have far as with these vehicles?
So the vehicles will be pool vehicles for planning and development.
Okay.
And what that means is that for those people that need to go out on site for any of the divisions within planning and development, whether that be community development, economic development, planning, or inspectional services, they'll be able to use those cars as a pooled, you know, set of vehicles to go do that work. Now, our priority is those inspectional services. And that doesn't just include housing inspection, but also zoning inspection. And that would be my expectation for the primary use of these vehicles. And so when you look at the staffing for that, we will, upon getting to full staff, we'll have 6 housing inspectors, a zoning inspector, and we will have additionally a chief inspector, a property investigator, and potentially other people who may use it, like our, the director of housing inspections, otherwise known as our building commissioner, who may use those autos as well. So it's a larger number of people than cars, but they won't all be using all of them at the same time.
Just wanted to make sure that, you know, you had enough staff with enough cars, so when you do come back later, I have an idea of what the usage of people versus cars.
Absolutely.
And you said we have cars additionally already.
We currently
do. That still will be in use.
Correct.
Correct. All right. Thank you.
Mayor, will you be having painted on the car the city logo so people know when they come out that it is a city inspector?
It likely will not be painted, but yes, we will have the logo affixed to the cars.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions? Okay, since this is being passed on first reading, let's do a roll call.
Maddox?
Aye.
Russell?
Aye.
Hart?
Aye.
Cobb?
Aye.
Kuda?
Aye.
Larson?
Aye.
Motion passed. That is our business for today, so we are adjourned.
Thank you, Council. Thank you.